Hello and welcome back, everyone. We have upgraded our production quality. Who would have guessed it?
We fixed the vision mixer.
We fixed the vision mix. That's what matters most. Welcome back. We are in our grand final stage. We have got Harrison taking on Alfie.
It's been an exceptional tournament so far. We've seen some incredible play from every single player that's come here. I'd like to put a round of applause up to everyone that's attended today and put in their best showing.
Well done, guys. Great work today.
But it's all come down to this now. Grand final.
And both of them have looked strong throughout. Alfie with the highest goal difference out of any player in it. He scored 16 in one game.
Undefeated so far, I'd like to add on to that as well.
He is indeed.
Yet to lose a game.
And so is Harrison. Both of them undefeated. I think that's kind of how it works, you know. Kind of helps. It shows that they probably can win quite a few games.
Topped their group and then continued to dominate onwards through into that playoff bracket. So, for everything here.
What more can you ask for? And they are playing for everything. And, you know, Callum in the background, he's sneaking there. Look at him. He's going to wave. There he is. Look, there we go. Welcome. As we say, we are here for the Stoke City Community Trust half. What more can you ask for?
It's been brilliant working with Stoke today. I've had a blast. Everyone that's come along has just been incredible to work with. It's been great fun. We've had fun since 9 o'clock this morning, so I can't wait to just see how it wraps up today.
That is the thing. It is going to have to wrap up at some point. And this game that we're going to have today, this one between Harrison and Alfie, is the one that's going to wrap it up.
It is indeed.
What more can we ask for? Probably going to be getting in game sooner rather than later. Cool. We will be getting in game soon. What teams are you expecting both of them to play?
I'm expecting at least one PSG pick coming in. Possibly two. We just saw in our semi-final match everyone playing PSG. So I'm expecting a lot of PSG coming into this. Maybe we'll see some upset picks though.
You know, both teams, both players, they like PSG. It's kind of obvious. I think everyone as a football fan probably know why PSG is quite good. You sign Messi. You have Neymar and Mbappe, and
I mean, he's on the box art, Nathan. He's on the cover.
He is the cover star. It's almost as if they're on the cover, they're good. Quite good.
Yeah.
Who would have guessed it? World football.
I mean,
Jack Wilshere. FIFA. Hold on, wait. That can't be right because Jack Wilshere was on one of the covers, and he weren't very good.
I don't know. You're speaking to me. I've never owned a FIFA game.
You're not a football fan either, so
I'm sitting here, guys, to add in the oohs and ahs to Nathan's casting. Yes. Give a bit more diversity. I can go ooh.
A different voice, so you don't have to listen to me shout, let's go, 24/7, and speak very loudly in your ear. But, as we say, Harv, we're here with Stoke. We probably should have made them play as Stoke in the final. That would have been quite interesting.
Someone earlier in the group stage matches won 4-3 as Stoke against Barca.
Just the better player. Shows, as you see, guys, we can confirm Barcelona are worse than Stoke City. We're definitely not biased, because, you know...
Definitely not.
Stoke. Let's go. Looking at the teams, they've both chosen PSG, and I think that kind of sums it up.
Yeah.
I think they were both going to pick PSG. Probably going to go for similar styles, and we're going to be heading in here. They're picking their teams. Different formations, though. One going for that more narrow 4-1-2-1-2. One looking at the 4-2-3-1 with the three cams. Me, as a player, I personally prefer to use that 4-2-3-1. Suits the team that they have. Playing that narrow style will force one of the good attackers that Barcelona have out of the game. Probably will be Di Maria, who has taken a back step, but they may have changed it up. They may play one of them as a centre mid, but PSG have a lot of good centre mids as well. They're actually having to change the settings. This is going to be Alfie. He likes to change it. He uses time finishing, something that we haven't seen many people do, but time finishing in the game can give you an advantage. If you time your shots well when you're meant to be connecting with the ball with the player, it adds that little bit of accuracy. It gives you that little advantage for being a more skilled player. Early push now by the team in white, looking to go very aggressively here, trying to play very slowly. Does manage to break it down. It seems like Messi's going to be playing in that more central midfield role here, trying to break now. Mbappe into Verratti, just slow build up from the blue side. Building up slowly, trying to break it down. He does intercept though. Building up nicely here. Lovely bit of play. Finds the ball out wide with Neymar, drilled into Idrissa Gueye, trying to find the pass, but it doesn't connect. He does intercept it there. Trying to build up slowly, looking to push onto them. Nice bit of play, nice ball coming through. Trying to find the ball out wide to Juan Bernat. Trying to build it now inside, but a nice interception by Marquinhos. Has to break on the counter now. That's a ball through to Neymar Cito. trying to find one. He has to get past Marquinhos though. Losing the sombrero flick, trying to evade that pressure by Marquinhos. Into the scoop turn, out wide, fake shot. Bit of a drag back, trying to build space. He's just using the skill moves nice and effectively here. Neymar with that 5-star skill, but a nice tackle coming through here. And that's going to be a corner.
Just to make this clear for the audience that's watching from home, Alfie is playing as the white PSG here.
Alfie
just to give some context to that there.
Yeah.
It's about as much as I can add in on top of my oohs and ahs, so I just thought I'd let you all know that.
That's something I had missed, so that does help. Yes, Alfie in the white, Harrison in the blue. Harrison on the attack now, that has helped me a lot. Thank you, Harv. Harrison on the attack, trying to build nicely here. He's gone for that more wide approach. Fires the ball out wide to Di Maria. He's looking to play it back inside. Nice interception though from Alfie, trying to break quickly here. 4-1-2-1-2 on this break, where you have numbers is what matters most. And Kylian Mbappe, as we've mentioned already, is the one to watch. He is the player to watch. Who is the one to watch for, though, out of these two teams? If they're both the same team, is a different question. Who's Mbappe really is the real question. But we shall see.
Mbappe-ception.
Mbappe-ception, indeed. That is, I don't think many people really wanted to think about that, but I guess we all are. Building up slowly here, Harrison looking to find the ball through. Intercepted by Alfie, but he does keep the ball. Very lucky to keep it there. Hakimi down the byline now to Verratti. Playing it down the middle now. Looking to build through the centre. Messi playing that central attacking midfield role. Looking to play that ball nicely. Building slowly, building effectively here, Harrison. He's playing that possession game. Something he hasn't really done previously, but he knows how good of a player Alfie can be. So he has to match him. He has to adapt his style, and it seems to be working for him. Finding space, nearly finding that ball through, but a nice interception by Alfie using Kimpembe.
This game much more even than many of the others that we've seen in the group bracket and the playoff bracket.
I mean, that's what you want to see though. Like, this is our grand finals. These are the two best players on the day when it comes to every single game. They've been the most consistent. Both have won all their games. They are consistently performing, and that's what you want to see. They are both doing their job. They are playing a very good match of FIFA. Pushing aggressively here now, Alfie looking to find the pass, finds the edge of box, and that's going to be a goal. A nice finish by Neymar via Alfie. 25 minutes played, and it's 1-0 to Alfie. A lovely finish coming through from him. Nice tackle though from Alfie. He's trying to break once again quickly. Just scored one. Can he break on the attack and find another? Mbappe, skill moves, trying to find the space. He finds the space. He drags out one. Nice save though from Donnarumma. He does get the save, and that's going to be a corner to Alfie. Alfie whips it into the box, finding Marquinhos' head. Does get beaten in the air. Harrison has to break now. Going for that quick break, but a nice bit of defending from Marco Verratti. And that's going to be put out for a throw-in to Harrison.
A relentless attack there, Nathan.
Some may say it was relentless. Some may say that the attack was very good. A very good
very
attack.
Very good.
It was good fodder, as some may say. It was a good fodder attack. Attacks from both sides, though. And, you know, Harrison, he's struggling to find that final third ball. Whereas Alfie, he's found that final third ball multiple times. Plays another one across to Mbappe, and that's going to be 2-0. And some may say a simple pass across, and some may call it a sweaty. Everyone's got a different iteration of the pass across the net. But it does go in, and that's going to be 2-0 to Alfie.
Some may say this was written in the stars with some of Alfie's dominant 12-0 performances that we saw in the group stages.
I mean, he's known for scoring goals. When you score 39 goals in 8 games, or yeah, 6 games in fact, weren't even 8 games, 6 games, that's really impressive. And you can see the players and the fans watching on as the game happens, both looking to get this underway. Not entirely sure, because I can't actually see the game, so I'm not sure what's going on.
We're watching it in the same quality you are on that little monitor there, so
there we go. Good as gold, back in game, 35 minutes played, still 2-0. Looking to break now, Harrison. Nice pass to Messi on the edge, trying to break free. Does get fouled though, that's going to be a free kick on the edge of the box. 21 yards out, Messi on the free kick, standing over it. Alfie moves his keeper. I'm not entirely sure about this free kick tackle. Not entirely sure about the placement either. And Di Maria, he blasts that over the bar.
I could have done better than that, Nathan.
You probably could have done. I think most of us could have done better than that, Harv, because you've got a box to aim it with. You know where you're going to put the free kick. You can choose where in the general area the ball will go.
That's just point and click. I can put my FPS talent to use there.
Yeah, but it's with a controller, Harvey. And as a mouse and keyboard player, I don't think you might have been able to, you know, that's move the stick and press circle. That's not point and click. That's move the stick and press. Break now from Harrison. Finds one, does get the rebound. Mbappe may be offside anyway, and he is in fact. It's going to stay 2-0. 41 minutes played on the clock here. Harrison needs to find a goal sooner rather than later. to keep him in this one. He wants to win this grand finals and end his day on top of everyone when it comes to it.
Yeah, he wants to go home with all the glory, taking this Community Cup home with him.
They don't win anything, though. That's what matters most. They're here for fun. And I think it's fair to say that they've all had fun. Everyone who's taken part, whether they've had a bit of a struggle in their games or they've got to this stage, as Harrison and Alfie have done, I'm sure they've all had fun. Finds Messi on the edge of the box. He doesn't connect, though. Coming up to half-time here into added time. Just 1 minute of added time. And Harrison needs to find something before the half ends. Whips it in. Going to hand straight to Donnarumma. And that's going to be half-time. 2-0 to Alfie. And I'm not entirely sure what production are doing. They look like they're having fun over there. Yeah, Luke's giving me the thumbs up. I'm guessing they're having a great time. And hello, we're back.
It's back to us, Nathan.
It is back to us. I mean, they're doing subs, so I guess that's why we're back at us. And I wasn't expecting to see me again.
I wasn't either, but that was a nicely close half.
No,
despite
not.
What the scoreline might have suggested, even though the half isn't quite done yet, as we've got seconds remaining.
We're in the second half now. Okay.
Interesting.
You saw us for about 2 seconds, people. Yeah, we're still here. We're still sat in the same chairs, still watching the game. But as we do, not entirely sure what's going on. But Harrison on the break here, he has to find a goal. As I say, he is down by two. And a two-goal lead is kind of a scary lead. You get one back in the game and you're in it. You're still alive in the series, but in a push coming through from Alfie down the line with Mbappe dribbling inside, finds Neymar. Neymar with the step over, plays it out, fake shot. La Croqueta on the edge of the box, trying to drive through, but a nice tackle coming through from Harrison. He does stay at 2-0.
Some may say 2-0 is one of the most misleading scorelines in all of esports.
Some may say that. I'm not entirely sure what esports game that is, because there's quite a few esports games where it's a bit different. But some iteration of a scoreline is the most misleading one, and today it has been 2-0 in our series so far. People have been coming back from this 2-0. This could be 3, in fact, and there's going to be Neymar. Ooh. That's going to be 3 for Alfie Harrison. At the end of the day, it is the end of the day, and he needs to find the goal.
He did the funny, Nathan. He did the soon.
Ronaldo, some may say. Manchester United. And Harrison needs to find one early here. He needs to get the goal sooner rather than later. Something I've said quite a lot, but it's quite true. It's a true phrase. Some may say it's a catchphrase, some may say it's a crutch phrase, but it's a true phrase.
Well, you can't leave it too late into the game, Nathan, otherwise there is no coming back. There's only a certain amount of time that you can score these goals in, and if he leaves it too late, it's GG all over.
Well, the thing is, he's got to get at least 3. You know, when it was 2-0, he had a bit more of a chance. It was only 2, and as we mentioned, 2-0 was the most misleading scoreline of the day. But 3-0, that's where people get a bit comfortable. That's where some people kind of get a bit nervous as well. Some of the players who need to find the goals, when they're not going their way and time keeps whittling down more and more, more mistakes may happen. And speaking of a mistake, this could lead to one right now on the edge of the box. Alfie trying to press with Messi, but he does get tackled. Falls back to Harrison. Kimpembe now trying to work his way up. Wijnaldum into Mbappe. Pushing very aggressively here. Has to run at his defender, and that's a dirty challenge coming through from Alfie. But he does break up play, and it's just going to be a yellow card to Ashraf Hakimi. Building up nicely though, Harrison. Trying to work it on the edge of the box. He does get intercepted. Kimpembe, in fact. Not Hakimi. Does get the tackle, and that's going to lead to an Mbappe counter-attack down the line. Down this left-hand flank. He does get tackled. He does get nicely won back though. Harrison needs to get the ball. A nice sombrero flick coming through from Alfie. Finds Messi. Nice save from Donnarumma. Going to fall back to Alfie, in fact. Nearly fell back to Harrison, but it's a nice play. Going to go for another sombrero flick. Alfie, he's having fun now. Just trying to go for them skill goals. Messi on the edge. Green finesse. Green time finish. And that's going to be 4-0. 66 minutes played in Harrison. Some may say if you write them out, they will come back. So we're going to do the caster's curse, half. We're going to try it. Harrison can still win this.
He can still win this. Although he is showing that he's maybe a bit wobbly on the sticks, when Alfie's just showing he's got that raw speed on him.
Wobbly on the sticks. Some may say wobble on the sticks may lead to a wombo combo. And the wombo combo that Alfie's experiencing right now from Harrison's wobbles on the sticks is 4 goals in his favour. Aggressive push now though. Verratti working his way forward. Harrison, he needs to get one to start it. Doesn't go in though. Nice save from Donnarumma. And Harrison's not really found the goals when he probably should have. He's had quite a few chances that he needs to be scoring. And it's because, and I hate to say it, but we saw Alfie at the start of the game, and it goes just wide. Another save from Donnarumma. We saw Alfie at the start of the game turn on time finishing, and we mentioned it. If you're comfortable with it, if you know how to utilize that mechanic in the game, you will more likely than not score a couple extra goals. You'll have that added boost of being able to time your finishing, and that finesse shot on the edge of the box for Messi for the fourth was the one that mattered most. I'm not entirely sure what that was either, huh?
That was a funny noise in my headset there, Nathan.
You weren't the only one. An aggressive push here, though, from Harrison, working his way down the line. Going to look to play it inside, edge of the box, back post, but he nicely defended from Alfie once again. Falls to his left back, does get intercepted, and I think that shows it all. Passing stats looking very comfortable, though. Harrison, when he's going for this possession-based style, it's not really worked for him. He's adapted it to try and meet Alfie, see how he played, and it doesn't work. Alfie going for these more advantageous through balls, trying to split the defence, trying to go for more skillful moves. See, Neymar on the edge of the box here, working his way to the byline, ball roll, two turn back, finesse shot on the very edge, and that's going to be nice, easy save for Donnarumma. 80 minutes on the clock, just 10 minutes left for Harrison to even start a comeback, because none has been started yet. And this could help him. Mbappe running at the defence. A nice tackle, though, from Alfie with Kimpembe. Going to fall to Messi. He's on the break once again. This formation, though, has worked in Alfie's favour. Going to this 4-1-2-1-2. Playing this narrow style of playing with Neymar and Mbappe in central strikers. Messi at the cam position. And you just pull the ball to him on the edge of the box in cam. And you can go for them green time finesse shots as Alfie scored. Going to switch up the corner taker. Neymar to take. He's going to try and score from the corner. I already knew it was going to happen. A nice easy claim for Donnarumma.
The comeback's starting to look insurmountable here, Nathan.
I think the cast of curse worked backwards. I don't think it worked. We should have said it the other way around. Alfie was going to not concede, and then he would have conceded. You know what? Alfie's not going to concede anymore. Let's get one, Harrison. Consolation goal. It could come, but a pretty poor through ball from Marco Verratti leads to a nice, easy claim from Alfie. And he's wasting time at 4-0 half. He's calming it down. He's holding the ball with his keeper, and he's just, I mean, the time waste was a bit pointless. He's just booted it out for a throw to Harrison. 2 minutes plus stoppage left for Harrison in this game. Needs to find a goal. Just one. That's what we want. One to end the day. But it's looking less and less likely unless he can find something here. Nice over the top through ball, but he's going to be called for offside. Pressed early here. Going to play the ball out wide to Wan-Bissaka. He's just going to waste time. Just 30 seconds on the clock. Going down nice and quickly. And I think that's going to be 4-0 to Alfie. And it will end 4-0 to Alfie. And a very comfortable tournament for him today. Round of applause for them. We'll do a round of applause for you guys. You know, well
round
done.
Of applause for Alfie there today, not dropping a single match. Didn't taking every single one that he played.
I mean, that just shows dominance. That shows how good of a FIFA player he is. And what more can we ask for?
I mean, we had some very high quality games there. We experienced some great underdog stories. Kit coming out of nowhere to bring it into the semis. You know, AJ absolutely dominating in the group stages, not dropping a single match and winning on goal difference. We saw some incredible games today, and it was great fun, wasn't it?
It was fun, and that's what matters most. We may potentially, and I mean this is potential, we might be ending up having an interview here. A very cheeky interview with some of our players of the day, and I think potentially we will. Does Harrison want to come on? He don't want to come on. He's not fancying it. I don't think he's happy with his performance in that final.
I've just been flashbanged by production there,
flashbang
Nathan.
Flashbang has come on. Very, very bright light. Ba-dum, into our face. And that is what we like to see. That's fine. We are going to have an interview. We are going to end it there. Harvey, any last words?
It's just been a great day, Nathan. I've enjoyed it, every single moment of it today. I'm sure everyone else has, and it's just been brilliant to see everyone down here at campus today.
It has, you know, nice run up to Christmas. Nice last thing here at Staffs for us as students, as people involved with the Stoke Community Trust, for something before Christmas for everyone to enjoy.
Indeed it was, Nathan, but I assume that's us signing off here then.
I think it is indeed. We are going to be signing off. Thank you everyone for watching us today. And hopefully, we will be back at some point in the future.
We can only hope so.
We can only hope so. Doing another one. We will see you next time.